So, you know, today is a bumper crop for information on demonry. I was just coming back home and I stopped here because I've got some new intel. It's very interesting. Let's see. As it turns out, one of the primary aims, I've just spoken of this before, one of the primary aims of demonry is to turn humans one against the other. And they do this by influencing their autonomic nervous system with rote messages, as well as their conscious minds with programming of an electrical nature that short circuits the normal function of the neurons. They have like very sophisticated machines that allow them to do this. And if you can ever get them to leave off terraforming you, they will actually take these machines off of the astral, off of the etheric net, and take it with them in case they can prudently use it elsewhere. So anyway, getting back to this situation of them creating, turning one human against the other, Cain and Abel, right? The oldest story, or the second oldest. The very first rule that we learn from such great Indian teachers as Patanjali is do no harm. And also from the Buddhists, harm no one, harm no human being. So we start there. We start there, and no matter what we think we heard or saw or imagined about another human being, we always forgive. We always give them the benefit of the doubt, okay? Now, so first, we humans, we're all friends together. And we know when we notice demonry establishing itself in someone, here's how we can be of assistance. We ask the demon world, I demand to see the contract. What right have you to be in this person? And they will have to produce that contract, okay? Now, and then you have to find out how to annul that contract, how to void it. I can recall some things that are the most important things, I think, that allow a buy-in from the demon world. And those are dealing with taking drugs or either alcohol or, you know, what they call recreational drugs into the physical system automatically says to the demon world, I am willing to give you my free will. Because that act removes some of our conscious safeguards of our behavior. It loosens our conscience, and they know that to be a statement that we are ceding power to them. Then another thing that we can do, very obviously, is to practice the black arts, and that is to use the power of this great earth, or the sky, or the electromagnetic field of people, to use the words that we have of power and emotion for the purpose of harming other beings, other human beings on earth. And what that does is that aligns us. The intention may be to gain power, to gain sexual power or money or any form of power, but that desire for power aligns us with the demon world. Okay, it's only through love that we can align ourselves directly with humankind and overcome the demon world. Okay, so that's just a little background. There is some information that others say it has to do with homosexuality. And some Christian texts say that homosexuality, the practice of homosexuality, actually gives permission to the demon world to come in. I don't know what to say about that, because people do have a right to express themselves, I feel, sexually any way that they want. But I believe that practice of feelings of hatred or feelings of being harmed of during the act of sex, no matter what the modality, whether it's heterosexual sexuality or homosexual sexual expression or whatever other way of expressing oneself sexually, if it involves injury, that does give entry that gives permission for the demon world to come into a person. And that could be how that law that you frequently see came to be construed. I think it was construed to straight across the board. It should have been explained as a doing of harm rather than... And we humans, we do harm to other humans when we judge them on the basis of their sexuality or of anything. So we buy into the demon world when we judge other people. And I think that's what it is that upset me so much about that particular idea. Forgiveness, on the other hand, is the exact opposite. Now, to get back to this thing that happened to me just now, I was driving down the road and I got to thinking about a group of spiritual people far from here that I had heard about, and that seemed to be like the feeling that I got from far away, like just from looking at it, that information on the internet, was that somehow or other they had absorbed some principles in their early times or through their first teachers that had led to like some kind of buy-in to the demon world. Okay, and I was concerned about that because we humans, we need to stand by each other. So I asked, I asked the demon world, I said, I'd like to see that contract. And they said, well, we know that he supported the demon world because he wore nice clothes. This was one of the original teachers over there. He wore nice clothes, so therefore he was arrogant. And so I thought for a minute, and I actually asked my team for help, which is a very good idea, my celestial ascension team. And they said... And I repeated to this spokesman for the demon world, they said, well, we know you are a proud race and you wear no clothes, so your statement is not logical. So then I said, well, so show me the contract. What other reasons have you? And there was a pause, a pregnant pause, and then the spokesman said, actually, that was our only reason. So then I turned to the members of that group and I said to those that I knew of, I said, do you of your own free will choose to evict the demon leagues from your physical, from your body? And they said yes. And so I said to the, just a minute. So then I said to the spokesman, I said, all right, take all your gear, take all your people, and remove yourselves from these terraformed bodies. And so then I said to the people, now, you're going to have to follow up on this and talk to the other people around there and let them know how to go about doing it, right? Because it's really our own responsibility, each of us, to make sure that we're clear of all that. Yeah. And so from that, I'm deducing, see, this is why I'm so excited about this. I'm deducing that this may be the first step towards a protocol to rid ourselves and our groups of all of these possibilities. We need to examine the contract. They must show us the contract. We need to find what loophole they found, because no human being would, in their greatest awareness, in their greatest sentience, would never cede their... Not knowing the consequences, would never cede their free will. Sometimes they cede it for superpowers. They want superpowers, and they don't know that that means they'll be inhabited by the demon world from then on. All right. So when that happens, like one time I did a meditation, a Drishti Lochini Karma meditation. I think there was something about that meditation, because it said you can talk to people from a distance, right? I was thinking, cheap phone calls for my mom, you know? But I think they interpreted that as a request for those superpowers that Patanjali warns against. And so if you make that mistake, as I did, the thing to do is to go back and say, this contract, spiritual team, this contract is null and void and canceled forever. The contract is torn up. That way they can't deconstruct the whole thing like a black mass and change it and make it not true. It's annulled and canceled and torn up forever for the all through free will, right? So nothing that we've said to them cannot be undone, because we have been tricked and fooled in some way by very crafty individuals. They have a theory, I consider it to be an invalid theory, that they can reverse positive things that we say by saying something similar wording that's the opposite, that has an opposite meaning. For instance, to counteract the Catholic Mass, which used to be the Christian Mass, said in Latin, they had proponents who advocated their cause for the sake of their own power in the world. In other words, black magic practitioners and black arts practitioners, sorcerers and so forth, would say the holy Latin words of the Mass backwards in a format known as the Black Mass. And this was intended by the demon world to annul, to blot out the good effect of the Holy Mass on the world. And they use this technique of altering the meaning of something or conniving around to make the meaning something other than it was, in a left brain kind of way, to get their way to over us, to connive that that we have given up our free will. For instance, when I say, this is with regard to the demon world this time, I say, I cancel all contracts. That means when they think that I gave them my free will, for instance. I cancel all contracts for the all through free will, right? They will look for another word, like cancel, that can carry the opposite meaning of that. And they will say, I think she meant this, you know. Or if I use a word like terminate, they will look for to deconstruct that word in such a way that as to say, for instance, I'm talking about a specific term, next week it's going to be different, you know. So they have all kinds of tricky ways of using the left brain wording that we have, the good spells that we have for our own hearts and for our all humanity, and twisting them, distorting them in such a way that they seem to be the opposite. I don't know much about this, but I'm sure that you could find from other people the perfect wording to use that can't be controverted. I do have the activations of light, so those are the simpler the better. Very pure, clear understanding of what is going on, you know. So that's the best I can say right now, and I hope that others will contribute in the future to clarification of this field of obfuscation of language in the interests of enslaving humanity. On to the next thing. In your work, just there's a change of attitude that will remove from you the notion of the alliance with the demon world, and that is this: in your work, don't do what you do for yourself alone, but do it on behalf of all humankind, and that takes it out of the realm of my will and into this realm of selfless service. Okay? So I think, for instance, in copyrights, the wave of the future is going to be to make it in a way freeware for everybody to come out with things, to publish things, but to allow other people free access to what we have. I think that's going to be the way it is in the future, paying attention to the all instead of just to ourselves. A story is going around in the clairaudient realms that one of the game plans they have, they call it the master plan, right, which makes it sound consummately evil. Anyway, one of the game plans that they have is to target beings that are very brightly lit, which apparently are very easy to find on the astral plane, and they know about the process of ascension, and they are concerned about it. They're concerned for their own economic interests and outlooks as pirates of the high seas of the galaxy, and so are legitimate invaders, if you would hear them. And so they've been looking for ways to actually stop the process of ascension. Now, last night I told them, they had the question, because they have been going around systematically to all the people with great light and adding to them nightly all kinds of like gadgets and stuff that would stop the flow of the heart energy and prevent and like short circuit them and increase their sexual urge and increase their negative mental speaking like that. And without exception, they've done that to all the light workers by now. Okay. And so the idea was, if these people can't ascend, then the ascension process won't take place and we'll be able to continue business as usual, right? So last night I received a question on the clairaudient plane, I assumed from the demonic realm. The question was, has Earth already ascended? And I said, yes, it did. It ascended 2 years ago. And the people are coming to the realization that this is so, little by little, in carefully arranged sequence, and just as according to their own soul nature and their own free will and like that. And so then there was a pause, and then I heard, oh, so it's too late. I hope that helps, you know. I hope that helps our cause. So, here's more story. I heard that a few years ago, after the ascension, in the months following the ascension, September to December, ascension process that took place on planet Earth, something happened with like the air, I guess, of Earth, and it made it not very appealing to the demon world. And so they have the capacity, the demon world has the capacity to be very small or very large. Lately I've been sensing that in the human form, as they terraform, they're about the size, a tenth the size of a tiny gnat. And I saw one jump out on the trail the other day to the size of about 2.5 feet by 8 inches. They're not like gigantic like they were before. You know, it used to be something like, could be as big as 4 feet by 15 feet as a manifestation on Earth about 10 or 12 years ago. And so something has happened to make them smaller. So it's like a situation, it's like a strategic situation. Humankind has dealt with worse things. There was the Great Ice Age, for instance. There have been lots of floods, they say worldwide floods at one point. There have been a lot of things that we've dealt with, and as a species, we've always succeeded by sticking together and being friends with each other and overcoming a common enemy, which is the situation we have here right now. Well, so the intel is coming in a mile a minute today, and I have updated information for you already. And that is that some of the demons that are like hanging around us and like stuck to our etheric net and like that are not there by choice. They're not necessarily all hiding out from the ascension process. It seems that ancient contracts maybe set by sorcerers in the old days, the many centuries ago, or perhaps by astral entities, or who knows, even human beings in the present times, have bound some of the demons to human forms. Now, we don't want this. So I don't know why, just out of the blue, I was sitting outside, and I said, I looked down at my physical form, and I said, you are free, go where you will. Everywhere where I sense like movement or like a peculiarity in my physical form. And I'll be darned if it didn't work immediately. There was like a huge flock of little beings flying out of my body and going off somewhere. For a while they like clustered around my head and they said, thank you, Dharmdi, thank you, Dharmdi. That was my old spiritual name. And I said, just okay, go. And they went off. So give it a try. It's so simple. And I would do it every morning. Why not? Why not free everything that might be bound to us? All right, this is probably the last thing on this particular video. Go in God. Be at peace. May love surround you all your days.